Today we'll take a first look at The Mandalorian and Grogu. Coming up. Hello everyone, Manufa Collectibles here with yet another Hot Toys figure preview. And today we'll take a look at The Mandalorian and Grogu Deluxe Edition. Guys, I have to tell you, we called this many lifetimes ago, and I'm so happy this is a reality. But before we start, if you are new to the channel and you want to check out the latest Hot Toys releases, posting videos, figure previews, and now comparison videos, make sure you hit the subscribe button and bell notification icon so you don't miss anything. Alright guys, enough with the talking, we came here to see Mando, so without further ado, let's get started. Alright guys, so this one comes with two different versions. We have the deluxe, which is this one that we're gonna take a look now, and of course the regular version, which also we're gonna take a look, plus the suit bike. So now, I have to tell you, the very first impression is very positive. I really, really like this release. I have some thoughts about the head sculpt, which it could be just me, but I'm gonna share it with you so you guys, you know what's going on. And we have here Din Djarin's head sculpt looking awesome, and then we have the armor itself, very shiny, and there is a difference, because it is a difference. Then we have all this bunch of accessories, especially this awesome Boba Fett helmet, and I really like the paint application. And as you can see here, we have this green with some, you know, weathering, and of course more Grogu. Yes, Grogu mania is happening. This is the thing now, so get ready, because we're gonna see a bunch of Grogu's, which is not bad, by all means is not bad. Now this is the difference that I was telling you about. So on the left we have the previous Beskar release, which is not as shinier as the new one, and you can see there is a difference. Now the question is, would Have Toys would have done this before, you know, with the shininess like that? Yes, they could have done it, but they didn't do it. So the fact is that now we have to get a new version so we can get the most accurate armor possible. Does this look bad? By all means it doesn't. I really like it. Both versions does look awesome, but the shiny on the armor, I think it will make a difference for sure, right? So now moving on to the next one, you can see the details as well, and you can see the armors on the legs, and of course the knee armor, if you will. And the difference on the previous version is that this one didn't come with that one, so that's a difference, right? And also the cape, right? You can see the cape is longer here, and this cape is shorter with some damage effect, right? So moving on to the next one, we have more accessories here, and this looks to me like Tusken Raider accessories. I can be wrong, but very nicely done as well. Then we have, of course, the dark saber, which in my opinion does look awesome. I really like the paint application. You can see the black with some silver colors here and there, and of course the spear. Yes, we're gonna have a spear. Now moving on to the next one, we have Din Djarin's head sculpt, and I'm gonna be very honest with you guys, it doesn't look bad to me. Again, this is the prototype, so it could be a huge difference from the prototype to the final product, but I think it is okay. I don't think this is perfect. This is just me. I can be wrong, of course. And it doesn't look bad to me, but I love the paint application. I love the wrinkles and the details, especially the texture on the skin. It does look nice. But again, this is just a prototype, so let's wait for the final product and then we'll have a better judgment and opinion, right? So now this one here looks awesome as well. And I took the time to kind of compare this head sculpt with this actual real life person, and obviously you will never get a head sculpt 100%. You will never get it, I understand that, but I think to me it's a bit off. I don't know if it's on the eyes. I think it's just too sad of a look compared to this. Maybe it's me, but nevertheless it does look nice. I think Hot Toys did a good job on this one. Again, let's hope for the final product and, you know, see it in hand. But you can see the expression on the eyes is just a bit different on this one. And I guess because it's different scenes and they're trying to get one particular expression when they do the Hascope, and I understand that. But don't worry, we're gonna talk more in depth tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern Time in our very special live stream with, you know, the bartender himself, Aries from Seals Club Cantina, and the artist, Desi from Metamorphic Customs. So stay tuned, 9 p.m. tonight. So moving on to the figure, you can see Grogu here. We have the spear. Finally, we have the spear looking very nice. Of course, paint application is excellent. Then we have more pictures here and pretty much same Mando. It looks to me, though, and I can be wrong, that they removed the fat suit. You can see the pants a bit baggier. I don't know if it's me. I don't know if I'm just overlooking, but you'll be the judge. But overall, the body itself looks nice. Very nice pose. And I think the cape is wired. And that's another addition to this set. And I think Hot Toys is listening to us, finally. And they doing some minor upgrades here and there. So moving on to the next picture. This is a very dynamic one. I really like it. You can see the details as well, the armor, which is pretty much similar to the Beskar, with some minor additions, if you will. And I'm very happy with it. Then we have the Soup Bike. And this one, by all means, is going to be the selling point if you're going to get the Soup Bike, because, you know, it's big. But it does look nice. Really like the paint application. Love the details, as always. And this picture is just the money. It's lovely. I love that picture. Then we have this one, and you can see Boba Fett's jetpack. Now, will that be a possibility that we might see the character that was wearing this suit? I can't remember the name now, because I'm old. The suit when Mandalorian found him. It is a possibility? I don't know. I don't know. Like my friend Ares will say, is it possible? I will say maybe. Maybe it is possible. Who knows? Moving on to the next one, we have more accessories here. Of course, Mando holding Grogu, which is pretty much the same as the Beskar release. So really nothing new in this area. But now you can see more details of the accessories that this figure comes with. And again, this is the deluxe version. You can see the Jarin's Hascope. And again, I love it. I like it. I still think that it's a bit off, just me personally, but it's really not a bad look at all if you compare it, obviously, with this, right? So then moving on to the next one, more accessories here with Mando. Really like this. This helmet is beautiful. So I'm telling you, I love it. And this is basically all this deluxe figure comes with. And as you can see, it's a bunch of accessories. We have the jetpack, we have the helmet of Boba Fett, we have some other accessories here, some Tusken Raider accessories. We have the Darksaber, finally. We have the spear, the same accessories that came with the Beskar version, the same base. Come on, Hot Toys, give us a new base. You know, you did all this job, just give us a new one, something different. Just put a rock or something. I don't know, just do something different. Same reusable base, same hands. Grogu looking cute as always, and of course the Din Djarin's Hascope, which does look good in my opinion as well. So now this is the deluxe. Now this is the regular version, which pretty much is everything from the previous without the Tusken Raiders accessory. So it doesn't come with this exclusive accessories with, you know, Boba Fett's helmet and jetpack. So that's the big difference between the two. Now for the next one, we have the Soup Bike, and this one looks awesome as well. Really like the weathering, really like everything that this comes with. So let's move on and take a look at more pictures. This is the same picture we've seen before with Mando riding the Soup Bike, and I love it. I like the details. Hato did a really good job with the speeder bike that came with the Scout Trooper, so I think they are going in the right direction, so I like that. Now we have Grogu again, I think. Yes, we have a Grogu, of course, with a cute, you see, this is kind of different now because the ears are more like, I guess, you know, going back, I think. But really like it, you know. And I told you, we're going to get so many Grogus. So Grogu Mania is a reality. But he looks cute. So why not? Why not? Really like the base. Very similar to the speeder bike that came with the Scout Trooper. And of course, this money shot with a Mando on the speeder bike. I really like it. All the details looking beautiful. And this is basically this this speed bike comes with, and of course Grogu, which looks awesome in my opinion. Alright guys, so this is gonna take me to my final thoughts about this figure and swoop bike and everything else. So the question is, am I gonna love it or hate it? And guys, you know, come on, you know the answer. I'm gonna love it. Of course I'm gonna love it, because it is a Star Wars, it is the Mandalorian, it comes with Din Djarin's Huskop. I mean, what's not to love about this figure? Is the Huskop 100%? Of course not. It will never be. It will never be 100% any Huskop, right? It's a bit off. Yes, to me it is a bit off, but it could be me. That doesn't mean that you're gonna follow what I said or you're gonna agree with what I said. By all means, you can disagree. If it's perfect to you, hey, it's perfect. That's fine. Just my personal opinion. I'm gonna definitely love this figure. Now, I don't know when this figure is coming up. I'm thinking it's next year, sometime next year. You know, I don't think Sideshow put anything on their website. It is very early in the morning, so I don't think we have that information yet. But if you want to get this figure or any other Day 1 releases, make sure you check out Day 1 Collectibles. I put the link in the description below, or INLC Toys as well. So I put both links in the description below. If you have points, go to Sideshow. Or you can contact my friend Ray at Howard's Toys, and he can definitely give you this figure as well when it comes out. So that's basically it for me, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget that we're going to have a live stream tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern Time with my friend Aris from Cisco Cantina, Desi from Metamorphic Customs, and of course, me. We're going to have an awesome live stream, which we're going to talk about this figure as well. And stay tuned for episode 2 of our 6-scale and filter. First episode was a success. A lot of people loved it. Of course, we have some people that didn't like it, which is fine. The purpose of this show is to give you news and give you something different. So I really hope you guys liked it. Episode 2 is coming very soon. Izzy and myself are working on it, so stay tuned for that. And if you have some time, check out these two cool videos. And as always, be well and see you around.